got the pleasure to sit down with a mother and her son the other day for a consultation, which I said was awesome to the son. He's 17 years old, and I commended him for coming in because at that age, I mean, he's taking control of his health and fitness, and he wants to learn how to eat healthy, and he wants to learn how to exercise correctly. I said, these are skills that you're going to learn and use with you for the rest of your life. And then I commended the mother for bringing him into as well, because oftentimes as parents, we obviously want the best for our children, and we often don't know where to seek that out. So she was coming not only for herself, but also for him. It was interesting, though, the dynamic when we started to talk about a little bit about their nutrition. I was talking with the mother and what she eats for breakfast, and she says she typically skips it. Well, when I went to the son, I said, well, what do you eat? He said, well, I eat typically eggs every morning. I said, that's awesome. Eggs, one of the single best protein source there is. All the essential amino acids you need from food, good healthy fat. So keep that. If you can win the morning by eating a good breakfast, you can win the day. And he said, yeah, mom makes it for me. I said, well, wait a minute. Mom skipped breakfast, yet she makes her son the eggs. I said, why don't you eat them? Why don't you make yours? I don't know. I'm busy taking care of everybody else. I said, there's the problem. I said, look, I see this all the time with mothers who take care of everybody else first and foremost and put themselves on the back burner. And I asked her the question. I said, if you fly and you have a dependent, not maybe not your 17-year-old son, but maybe a 2-year-old, and the oxygen mask drops down, who gets that oxygen mask first? And she said, well, my child. And I said, no, that's wrong. I said, you. Because at the end of the day, you dead does them no good. I said, you have to take care of you first. I said, it's awesome that you're here. It's awesome you brought your son. You're carving out the time now to make it a commitment for you to be able to take care of you. And I want you to be selfish. Not in a bad way, but in a good way, because if she could take care of her health and fitness, everything else in life is gonna get better. We see that all the time. If you can master your body, you can master your mind because you develop discipline. And then everything else, it'll permeate into everything else in your life. So I said, you gotta be selfish. Make time for you. Make time to come in and train twice a week. Make time to make the healthy breakfast with your son, but also make it for you. And as you start to get better and feel better and look better, now all of a sudden you start to take care of everybody else at a much higher level. So whether you're a caretaker or taking care of the overgrown child, if you're a mother and a wife, like I am to my wife, so I can affectionately say that. If you got kids to take care of you first, because you need to lead by example. They're gonna see mom eating healthy, they're gonna see mom exercising. So whether you're a female or male caregiver, it doesn't matter. Make the time for you. And I guarantee you'll never regret it.